everyone, this is the part 5th of September current affairs 2018, and as you know, the SEBI exam is around the corner, probably on the 17th of November. These current affairs are very important as we are expecting the current affairs from last 5 to 6 months in the examination. Also, the RBI assistant notification is expected to be come in the month of October, and the current affairs are even asked in the mains examination of RBI assistant and IBPS PO as well. So be prepared for these examinations through these current affairs. Let's begin with the question first of the part 5th of September current affairs. Where is the first ever corn festival organized in India? In the state of Madhya Pradesh, the first ever corn festival of the country was organized, and it was held in Chindwara in Madhya Pradesh, and this festival is one of the first of its kind international event. Along with this, if we talk about Madhya Pradesh, then Madhya Pradesh is one of the largest corn producer states in India. It is among the largest corn producer states. So Madhya Pradesh has organized this first ever corn festival. Next question is, recently Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has partnered with Google to launch the So, the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs under the aegis of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan or Swachh Bharat Mission, they have partnered with Google to launch the Loo Review Campaign. Loo Review Campaign or the Toilet Review Campaign has been launched under this partnership. Through this partnership, they would encourage all the local guides in India to rate and review. So you would be able to rate and review public toilets on the Google Maps. So Google Maps would be providing you the location of those public toilets available, and you would be able, or the local guides would be able to rate review the public toilets. Apart from the rating and review, you would be, or the citizens would be able to locate the public toilets available in their cities. Next is, Avya Indra is the joint Air Force exercise between which countries? So in the part 2 of the September current affairs, I have discussed the different military exercise which is being done by the India and other countries. So Avya Indra is the joint for Air Force exercise between Russia and India. We could see AVI Air stands for aviation. The IND could be from the India and RA from Russia. Quite easy decoding of this AVN joint Air Force exercise. Next is, which of the following festival is known as the Kumbh Mela of Himalayas? The Naropa festival is known as the Kumbh Mela of Himalayas, and in for this year 2018, to mark the end of this Naropa festival, a total of 299 women were dressed up in the traditional Ladakhi wedding attire, creating a Guinness World Record, and it has been declared as the largest dance performance and is known as the largest Ladakhi dance. Which state has become the first state in North India to introduce smart e-public distribution system? So Arunachal Pradesh has become the first state in the Northeast. The Northeast states to introduce this smart e-public distribution system. And what is this e-public distribution system? So it provides a centralized online retail electronic public distribution system so that the efficiency could be improved and it becomes easier for supplying the commodities to the beneficiaries. Therefore, the smart e-public distribution system has been introduced for the first time in the Northeastern states in Arunachal Pradesh. Where is the Pakyong Airport located? So the Sikkim's first airport, known as the Pakyong Airport, which is also the 100th operational airport in the country, has been inaugurated in Sikkim. So two things regarding this Pakyong Airport: the first airport of Sikkim and the 100th operational airport of India. Which of the following countries does not have a dedicated quit line number for tobacco products? So recently, India has become the only SAARC countries to have this dedicated quit line number on the tobacco product, and it is 1800112356. This is the dedicated quit line number for the tobacco product, and India is the fourth such country in Asia after Thailand, Singapore, and मलेशिया. सो इंडिया, मलेशिया, थाईलैंड, सिंगापुर हैव दिस क्विट लाइन नंबर फॉर टोबैको प्रोडक्ट्स इन एशिया. आई एम जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट एशिया. एंड जापान डज नॉट हैव दिस क्विट लाइन नंबर ऑन टोबैको प्रोडक्ट्स. सो द आंसर इज जापान. नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट इज इंडियाज रैंक एज पर द स्टडी नेम इकोनॉमिक फ्रीडम इन द वर्ल्ड कंडक्टेड बाय द सेंटर फॉर सिविल सोसाइटी. सो इंडिया हैज़ बीन रैंक्ड आउट ऑफ द 162 कंट्रीज इन द इकोनॉमिक फ्रीडम. एंड दिस 2018, दिस इज द 2018 रिपोर्ट एंड इट इज़ बेस्ड ऑन द एस्टिमेशन ऑफ 2016. सो दिस इंडेक्स मेजर्स द फाइव एरियाज ऑफ इकोनॉमिक फ्रीडम. द फर्स्ट वन इज द साइज ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. नेक्स्ट इज द लीगल सिस्टम और द प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स, द फाइनेंशियल सिचुएशंस और द साउंड मनी. नेक्स्ट इज द फ्रीडम टू ट्रेड इंटरनेशनली. एंड लास्ट वन इज द रेगुलेशंस. सो दीज आर द फाइव एरियाज ऑन विच दिस इंडेक्स इज बीइंग बेस्ड. प्रीवियस ईयर, इन द प्रीवियस ईयर इंडिया वॉज रैंक 98. नाउ इट हैज इम्प्रूव टू 96. Which country has topped this index? So Hong Kong has been ranked at the first position and Singapore at the second position in terms of economic freedom in the world. Next question is, who has been appointed as the head of the Competition Law Review Committee? So recently a committee has been formed on the Corporate Social Responsibility 2018 and Injethi Srinivas, who is the Secretary of the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, has been named as the head or the chairman of this committee. This committee would recommend the guidelines for the better enactment or the enforcement of the provisions and will also come up with the outcomes of the CSR activities or the programs or the project which could be conducted by the companies. So Injethi Srinivas has been appointed as the head of the Competition Law Review Committee, which is based on the corporate social responsibility. Next question is, which state has declared cow as the Rashtra Mata? So Uttarakhand State Assembly, Uttarakhand State Assembly has declared cow as the Rashtra Mata or the mother of the nation. So this has been aimed towards the cow protection. The next question is, which country has rolled out the world's first hydrogen powered train? Very important question, very likely to come in the examination. So for the first time, the world's first hydrogen-powered train has been launched, and it has been launched by Germany. These hydrogen-powered trains are quite costly, but they are more eco-friendly technology. So Germany has launched this world's first hydrogen-powered train. Next question is, which country is set to become the world's first to double its tiger population as part of the World Wildlife Foundation's T into 2 program, that is Tiger double the tiger program. So Nepal is set to become the first country in the world. So it would become the first country in the world to double its tiger population. And it was estimated in the year 2009 that there are 121 tigers in Nepal. Now the number has increased to 235 tigers, nearly double the number. Next is, who will be the first private moon tourist to fly on big Falcon rocket of SpaceX around moon in 2023. Yusaku Maezawa, who is the Japanese businessman. He is the Japanese businessman and the first private moon tourist to fly on this big Falcon rocket. And he is the chief executive officer, the CEO of ZOZOTOWN. Next question is, the government has proposed amalgamation of which of the following banks to create India's third largest globally competitive bank? So government has proposed the amalgamation of Bank of Baroda, Dena Bank and Vijaya Bank to create the India's third largest globally competitive bank. And if you just remember that Dena Bank has been put under the prompt corrective action plan by RBI. Also, it has been barred from extending fresh loans. It is believed that after the merger, these banks or the entity, the combined entity, would have the better financial strength. Next and the last question is, recently which of the following exchange has received the SEBI approval to launch commodities derivative segment? So SEBI has allowed the National Stock Exchange NSE and Bombay Stock Exchange BSE to enter into this commodity derivative segment. And initially, the BSE will enter the commodity derivative segment with only the non-agriculture products or the commodities like metals, and later it will also include the agriculture commodities. Currently, we know that the commodity derivatives are largely traded on the multi-commodity exchange and the national commodity derivatives exchange. So these are the two stock exchanges on which the commodity derivatives are traded. Now, SEBI has given the approval to NSE and BSE to come up with this commodity derivatives segment. Very important question if we take into consideration the SEBI examination. This is all for the part fifth of the video. Do subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal. Share these videos with your friends and people who are preparing for the government exams. Do come up with the feedback in the comment section below. Press the bell icon so that you do not miss on any of the updates from the channel. We have an Infinity app which you can download and read the current affairs and attend the quiz as well. These questions are available in the quiz. And thank you so much for watching the video. We'll be coming up with the next video soon.